Okay, we are working on the new example on the analysis of statically determined frame. This frame is the a kind of steel frame having four members. If you recall the example that we have, I have the example with two pieces of the beam and column. And we also have the frame with two columns and one beam. And this beam has the two beams and two columns. And one beam BC is going to be the cantilever beam, okay, and attached to the joint at D, and has the column A support the joint D, and the beam DE connected to the column BE with the rigid connection again. By the shape like this, you may consider the support A as the roller, and support B by this figure is the pin. So we will draw the whole frame free body diagram, and then we will compute for the three reaction by using three equations of equilibrium. And then we separate the beam into four pieces, and we analyze the end shear force and end moment, and finally we draw the shear diagram and moment again by using graphical method. Okay, the free body diagram of the frame, we have this, we have the roller at A, we have the pin at B, so we hope have three unknown forces. The best way is tying to summation of the moment about B and then equal to zero. What we have is we take moment here. So the A sub Y has the line of action here. The distance from here to here is going to be 8 meters. And A sub Y gonna rotate clockwise. So the rotate clockwise is said to be positive, and it's going to be 8 times what? Times A sub Y. Okay, that is unknown. Gonna go by the psi, positive psi convention here. And then we have a lot of forces. The 6 kilonewton gonna rotate in opposite direction, the 10 kilonewton also. And this has the resultant also rotate in opposite direction. And you can see this is 7, this is 0.4. So the resultant is going to be 7 times 0.4. How many it is? It's going to be what? 2.8, right? Kilonewton. And then this distance going to be what? Going to be half of 7. It's going to be 3.5. So it's going to be 8 times A sub Y, and then minus what? 2.8 times what? Times 3.5. Okay, that's the first term. The 15 kilonewton produce no moment because the 15 kilonewton will cut the B. Okay. And then we have what? We have the 10. The 10 gonna go by the A sub Y, so the 10 gonna time 8, so it have minus 10. And 10 gonna time 8. Okay. And then we have the 6. Okay. 6 is gonna time the whole distance from here to here is 6. From here to here is 8, so it's gonna time 14. And then all of this is going to be zero. You put them into your calculation, you get this A sub Y to 21.725. Okay. And next, you go by the summation of F sub Y equal to 0. By summation, f sub y equals b sub y is up, so positive is up. We have the b sub y and b sub y plus 21 plus 21.725, and it's going to be minus 6 and minus 10, and then it's going to be what? B sub y plus this one minus 15 also, and it's going to be equal to 0. So this one is going to be 10, 25, 31 minus 21.725, that is going to be 9.278. okay, and the last one we have summation of f sub x equal to 0, and you have what? You have the b sub x in this direction, put it at positive, so you got this one as b sub x. And you have the resultant here was what? 2.8. so you got this equal to 2.8 kilonewton. Okay, that's, it's going to be 2.8, and then you finish finding the reaction. You separate the frame into four. Okay, initially it's three is okay, because the CDE is a hanging beam, can be. And don't forget the E. This time we need to consider, let me note this time, we need to consider the joint. Let me put it into the more light color to point this way. This we need to consider this, because this time the joist have the 15 kilonewton. Whenever you have the joist with the force, you cannot neglect it. But if you go to the previous example, you may see the force can transfer from like the end of the column to the end of the beam directly. That is because there is no forces and moment at the joist. Whenever it has, so you cannot neglect it. Okay, okay, and then we put the reaction that we have into the segment or the part of the stream. And then if we start over here, okay, we have the force over here. The force over here, we just summation of f sub y equal to 0. You will get this force equal to this, and there is no shear, no moment, since there are only two forces here. This is a two force member per se, and then this force going to transfer to act at the point D. Okay, and what the E going to have three force: normal force, shear force, and moment. So we skip to this part, and when you know this, you're going to have the axial force. And what is axial force going to be? The axial force by summation of f sub y equal to 0, and then you get this one of 9.275. and for this one, if you summation of x sub x equal to 0, you get this equal to the resultant force of this, which is going to be, if you remember, 7 times 0.4, that is going to be 2.8 kilonewton. And if you summation of x sub x equal to 0, the b sub x and this one gonna eliminate each other, so the force here gonna be 0. Okay, and the last one we can compute for the moment, okay, by summation of the moment about this point, about point E, and then this is gonna be 0. Before that, let me take a note on this. So this guy is gonna be what? 9.2275 and kilonewton. Okay, and this is going to be 0. And the moment when you take the moment at point E over here, you will get what? You will get the 2.8, this direction. The 2.8 is going to be in this direction. However, this one going to be in this direction. So the m sub e will plus what? Plus 2.8 time this one, 3.5 plus 2.8, and then this one time 3.5, and then 5, and go together. And the opposite direction, you got a 2.8 also, but it's gonna times 7, it's going to be minus 2.8 and time 7. This one gonna be equal to 0, and then you may get the m sub e by putting in your calculator. You may stop the video and try to do so. What do you get? Okay, you may have this 0 kilonewton. This is 9.275, and what is m sub e you get? This is going to be 9.8. okay, if this is going to be 9.8, it's going to be 9.8 here. The 9.275 is going to get upward. Okay, and then the shear is 0. And then what happened? This 9.275, this one is upward. Okay, this one is downward. So we need to have this one, okay, to make it in balance. So the shear here, the summation of F sub what? Sub Y equal to 0. The shear at the E, the shear is E, is upward. It's got a plus 9.275, plus 9.275, and then this up is going to be equal to the 15. Okay, you do the computation. This is 9.275, and this is going to be the blue one. That is going to be 5.725. The 15 minus 9.275. So this is going to be my V sub E. Okay, it's going to be this. How about the moment 9.8 here going to be this one going to be 9.8 also. So the moment here is going to be 9.8 or kilonewton, and the 9.84 going to be this one. Okay, and the blue is going to be this one. So we have 9.8, and this is 5.729, and that is 9.8 kilonewton. And then up until here, so you have the reaction here, you have the internal force here. So now you are ready to draw the shear diagram, moment diagram of every member. So let's start this one first. So this one we have this, and you may see the 9 kilonewton gonna put this one down, and then there is no distributed force. This is gonna be constant, and this one gonna take up, but you have 10 here, so it's going to up for 11.725. okay, and then it's going to constant here and cross here, so the shape could be down and up. Okay, so the shear will be like this. So the R is going to be like this, upward, downward, due to this 6 kilonewton. No distributed force. This is going to be 0. This is going to be minus 6. And green and black going to be deduct each other. That is going to be up for 11.725. So this is going to be minus 6 plus 11.725. And then we got this for 5.725. And then there is no distributed force. So the S over here is going to be 0. And then this is going to be plus 5.725. And then you get this downward shear. So this is going to be the downward. Take the downward bow here, and it's going to cause the shear diagram again. And then for the moment diagram, you may see on the left the moment gonna be 0. However, on the right, you're going to have the moment of 9.8 kilonewton meter. So the moment diagram, since this end has no moment, so start here with 0. And then since the shear here is minus 6, so the slope here S is going to be minus 6. And then what's going to be here is going to be M minus 0. M this minus 0 is going to be equal to, it's going to be equal to the area here. That means it's going to be equal to minus 6, and then it's going to time 6, okay? And then the M here is going to be minus 36 kilonewton meter, okay? And next, the slope going to be here. The dV by the XO, the slope change from minus 6 to plus 5.725, okay? And what is going to be the value of moment here? The M here is going to be M sub E. The M sub E here gonna minus 36 minus of the minus 36, okay? And then it's going to equal to what? It's going to equal to the area here. Okay, you may highlight the area here. The area here is going to be what? The area here is going to be 5.725. And then it's going to time, this is time 8, equal to 5.725. And then it's going to time the length of 8. So the M sub E, sorry for very unbeautiful drawing, the M sub E. The M sub E going to be here. It's going to be what? Going to be here. Oh, okay, I lost my calculator. It's okay. It's going to be 5.725 times S, and this one is minus minus and plus, and then it's moved to the right, it's going to be minus. So this one is going to be 9.80 kilonewton meter. And then you get what? You get the 9.8 here, in which it is what? Counterclockwise, and it's going to be negative. When it's negative, that means it's going to cross this one downward, okay, to cross this end. So that is the moment diagram of this beam CDE. And then for the column BE, okay, we project this, and should we have what? This is going to have the 2.8 due to what? Due to this b sub x. And then we have the slope of s equal to minus 0.4. Okay, so the graph here is supposed to be like this. And since the shear is zero, since the shear is zero here, this is with zero. That is going to be 2.8 and is negative. Okay, negative. And then the slope here, this is negative 2.8. Slope here is going to be what? Now what? No, it's going to be plus. Okay, because the force is from the left to the right is negative. So this one is for the right to the left. It's going to be positive. This taking care of the uniform load, the direction. If you consider the column with the uniform load from the left to the right, okay, that slope is negative. And from the right to the left, that slope is positive. So this is zero. And then for the moment diagram, we have the moment here for the zero. And then we have this one as the negative. So the slope here must be negative of 2.8. And then it's going to be reduced by the value of the shear. And then the slope somewhere here is going to be zero slope. Okay, the slope here is going to be zero. And the moment here is supposed to be 9.8. And it's going to be minus because it's on the right, on this side. Okay, from over here, zero. And then slope is negative. So this one is going to be minus 9.8 kilonewton meter. And the curve going to be like this one. Okay. And then we have 9.8 what clockwise. And then it's going to be positive. Okay. It's going to be like this and close the loop here. Okay. And that small column. The small column is you go back and taking care of the column. This column there is no shear diagram and there is no moment diagram. It already has the axial force diagram. So we only draw the shear diagram for the beam CDE, okay, and the shear and moment diagram from the column BE, and that is the example that we have.